right. Here's your first Sombravad, Dan. I'm messing with some audio settings, so I might cut out in a little bit, like every once in a while. It's just so you guys don't hear my annoying laptop fan.
So,
Let's get into it. Here we go.
attack commencing. Capture objective A. Marked.
At number one, you should always be stealth. Pretty much no matter what. Unless we'll probably get into that after this, but unless you're playing defensively. If you're playing like at the very start of a match, you just go, it just makes you go faster. Regardless of the invisibility helps or not. Yeah, this was really weird. I kinda go nuts on this map though, I'm not gonna lie. At this point the fight's over. You just wait. I'm just kinda doing my own thing. I'm trying to try to kill someone else here. I almost got it. Don't do that. I know you have issues translocating and stuff, but Sombra should never die like that. Ever.
Didn't see that coming.
So, playing this comp is a lot like playing Double Sniper, whereas you try to attack from multiple different angles at the same time, and confuse them on who to attack and where. What you just did, I had just left. There was no one else around, and then you popped out. And so they're all just gonna shoot at you. So what you should have done is waited for me to wrap back around and start shooting at people, and then you could start shooting at them from a different angle. Yeah. So, all right. We'll map this out here. Actually, because we're in a replay, we can just look at it right now. Right, so how do I go up? Right, so you can see. So here's me. Oh, oops. Here's me. Oh my gosh. Can I please? Let me use my pen. Match won't let me use my pen. I'm losing it. Okay, let's try that. It looks so much worse, but it might actually work. It just won't let me draw. Cool. Yeah, yes, I. This is obnoxious. It won't let me draw. Third person. Cool. All right, well. I think I might have done something stupid. I think I closed out something I wasn't supposed to. To try to get more frames, because I was sitting at like 30. There we go. Okay. So let's go back to where we were here. Whoops, whoa, whoops. Oh my gosh. Okay. So. Here's me. Here's Shawnee. Okay. Twigs is hiding by his van. Good positioning by him, by the way. And I believe this is Ice. And that's, I don't know, their Symmetra. So I'm attacking from this angle, right? Behind their shield, onto the Bastion, forcing him to move. That gives Ice the chance to kill him because he's going to be on the other side of the shield, or Twigs to nade him as well, okay? But I'm still firing on this side, so they can't go on this side, including the BAP as well. That, this is where you come in, right? You could be on this side of the shield. You could be in this room. There's a lot of different angles that you could come through that would kind of throw them off. Another option even would be to just sit on point and shoot from point. Okay. So you got like 1, 2, 3-ish options. But you're dead. So if we don't win this fight, that's on you. Because you died. Even though you had your translocator out. For whatever reason that might be. I'm pretty sure we just win because I'm amazing though. Also, if you haven't figured out yet, Arista has like the biggest head hitbox in the game. So, it's super easy to farm EMPF of her. Oh, look at that, dude. That's going nuts. Oh, there it is. We might have wanted to stay in this comp. I think we should have, for sure. You should be going up right now with your stealth and your translocator.
Objective A captured. Commence attack on objective B.
We went back. Enemy contact. Been here all along.
Feels like I'm just not doing anything.
Dein Schutzengel ist da.
Well, let's go with what you should be doing. Yes, this is fine, but you should be in with us. You should be hacking Bastion. Right now you're just doing nothing. So your job against Bastion is to hack him and get him out of turret form.
Dein Schutzengel ist da.
You had a chance. Well, I don't know. I don't know if you could have translocated it or not.
Beacon in place.
I still think this is a good swap. I don't know. I feel like we should have done something with it. I feel like we should have done better. Should have just won it, like straight up. So here's what you should have done. That. So the idea of Summer being able to go invisible is that she can go behind people without them knowing, and you can get in a position, be ready for an EMP, and when we get there, you just press Q, cancels everyone's abilities, and then we win the fight. So here's what you should have done, right? So you're just kind of sitting here on the side. You're sitting here. You're acting like you're playing McCree. You're sitting behind cover. You're kind of just poking at people that are outside. You don't have to do that, Asombra. This is a completely different play style than, like, every other character that you play, which I know, which is going to be a really difficult transition for you, but I think it'll be for the best in the long run. So what you should be right now is, while we're setting up ourselves, you should be getting set up behind Bastion. Right? So that you're sitting over... So... Oops. There we go. So, here's how they're set up, right? So, you can see what they're trying to do. If you look at it, right? So... Symmetra is just over here and ready to put down a teleporter to move them to that exact spot right here. Okay. Kree is looking for people with the damage boost to kind of pick off, and Bap is looking to heal the Orisa and the Bastion. Okay. And that's all six people. Okay. So what you should do is you should go around either, like, right side and go by the mini. There's a... There's a mini right here. Right there. You can set yourself up here and hack it. My recommendation would be to sit right here. Okay? Right by that sticker. And just kind of wait in the stairwell where they don't notice you. And then right when we turn this corner right here. So if we go up a little bit here. So we're going to be turning this corner here. And the second that we turn this corner, you walk out an EMP. Because we can also speed boost ourselves through this area right here. Okay. McCree, when we push up, he's going to back up to probably around to the Reinhardt, or the Orisa Shield. So you'll probably hit five people with an EMP right there. EMP has a really, really long, a really big range, right? So... If you were to EMP, I do one of two things, right? You can do one of two things when EMP is Sombra. You either throw your translocator into the air above their team and then decloak and hit everybody, okay? Or you put your translocator down somewhere, you walk in stealthed behind them, and then you decloak and EMP, okay? Those are your two options. What I would do personally is I would probably wait at this mini, and then when they're ready, I'd throw a translocator about, let's see if I can show you what I'm talking about here. I'd throw an EMP, like, right behind this statue right here. Right here. If this was like a ball right here, not on this pillar, but like a, like right behind the statue. You kind of get what I'm saying? So it'll hit the sim and it'll hit the bunker, right? It's because it's in the middle of both and has such a huge, massive range. Okay. You also have to get used to that. You don't have to be on top of people to EMP them. The range is ridiculously high. Symmetra has shields. So if you EMP Symmetra, she only has like 100 health left. So you just focus her down and kill her. And then everybody else can jump on Bastion. So we should have won this a million times over with this comp. And I knew I was right. Because I'm always right. Because no matter what comp we played there, we would have had to eventually hit everybody with one EMP and we win. Continuing, let's see. So instead, you just kind of sit here. Like on McCree. And then you break shield, even though no one's breaking shield with you. It doesn't really make any sense. Go in. They have ults. We don't use EMP. We have it. no use of the next fight, though, because they have Smash Roll. We should have won this next fight, too. I'm interested to see how we lose. Okay, so let's see if I can capture the exact moment this happens. Okay. You see how there's three people outside, including Bastion and Baptiste, that you didn't hit with EMP? Dude, that looks so cool. I caught that at like the perfect moment. That is so sick. Anyway, so you hit three people with EMP. If you would have translocated over, instead of just walking your happy little butt to this spot, if you would have translocated over here and then popped it, you would have hit everybody. And we would have won this fight. You rarely just want to walk in and do stuff as Sombra. Because stealth makes you faster, translocator makes you, you know, it gives you mobility. So, do you kind of see why we lost these fights? Because EMP is so, so crucial, and it's so, so good that if you mess it up, we're just gonna lose. And that's just the way it is. And you're gonna have to learn one way or another, so I might as well just sit here and hammer you about it until you get it right. Because look at this. Look at how the fight... So, if we watch Bastion's point of view, right? He's sitting here having a grand old time because he doesn't get hit by the EMP, and then watch. He just rolls on these things. Because we lost because we didn't hit the EMP cap back. That's why we lost. 100%. No other reason. We should have had it. So now that you don't have EMP, let's see how you play. You should be stealthing, translocating. Translocator has such a small cooldown that you can just throw it out of spawn. So what you should do out of spawn is immediately stealth and then throw a translocator and then just hop over and just be super fast and get to where you're going. Right now you just look like an idiot. Alright, so this is a good time to go over this now. So you got two play styles as Sombra, right? Let's say we're gonna get into a fight first before I explain this. Isn't this cool? Alright, so there's two playstyles of Sombra, right? to fight where you're on Sombra. So early. We're all swapping. What's with that bashing gun? Alright, so, here we are. Like I was saying, two playstyles of Sombra. There's offensive. Actually, I don't want this blue, I want it. Could I make it black? Would that be better? Yeah, that's fine. Alright, so you got offensive and defensive, okay? Let's make this a little bit cleaner here. Offense, defense. So, offensive, you play with the team. Or no. Omega lol. Defensive, you play with the team. And you hack people that keep dying. Okay. So, as Sombra, the question should be, right, who on their team is a threat, and how are they a threat? Okay, so, for example, right, say they have, they're running ball 3 DPS with a Doomfist, okay? Their biggest threats to your team are going to be the ball, right, and the Doomfist, because they're going to kill your backline, as well as the Pharah, but the Pharah's not your job, right? You can't really deal with Pharah very well. You can hack her out of the sky, but that's pretty a rare occurrence, okay? So, what's going to happen a lot is if you're running multiple DPS and an Ana, Ana's going to get dove a lot. So what you're going to want to do in that situation is stick with Ana and hack people that try to kill her, okay? Now, what if they're running goats, right? There's no one that's really a threat. They're just kind of a threat as a big ball, right? So you can then play offensive. Offensive is without the team, okay? The way you play offensive is that you build EMP as fast as possible, as well as trying to pick off any of the squishy supports. Like, Ana and Zen are super easy to pick off. If you hack Lucio, he's pretty easy to kill. Hack Mercy, she's pretty easy to kill. That kind of stuff, right? So, offensive is kind of like an assassin, whereas defense, you kind of work as, like, the hacker that she was kind of meant to be, whereas offense is, like, a better tracer. If that kind of makes sense, right? So, with goats on Sombra, especially against this comp, the threat that is killing everybody is Bastion. Bastion is not going to be in your backline. He's not going to be killing everybody. He's in his own little world over by Orisa. So you're going to want to play offensive route. You're going to want to build EMP as fast as possible and maybe try to get a possible pick. Okay? So, you try as like Ashe and Widow, your job is to find the head and click the head. That's your job. And then die to Monkey. That's pretty much sums up what you do. Like, but this is much, much more complicated, and it's going to take a while for you to figure out. So while we're all figuring this out, it's just going to be a rough time. You're going to lose us some fights like Leaf did today, and so did you. So, if you have questions after this, ask me. We'll go from there. Let's go back. And the
ready for battle.
The Zen stuff. This stuff, this was on Twigs. I'm not too worried about your bash and play. Just kill people that you see. We need to work on this. This was mostly Twigs. He didn't use his field correctly. And Ice and Shawnee had some disagreements, so I'm not to worry about the rest of that map. Oh my gosh, please, thank you. So let's move on to the next one here, which was Nepal.
traveling to Nepal. Ready for battle.
We should have won this, dude. I'm so upset that we didn't. I want to go to the point where we lose. Let's see what we can. I'll probably just watch this my own time. I'm not too worried about your inner play. You're not. You're gonna rarely have a player.
Nerf this. Mecha activated.
Alright, just for...
Team
kill. Should've had you move to Zen. No. Yeah, that's good. All that happened this map is that. Did you see that right there? Doomfist jumps in and kills you. That happened a lot. Twigs needed to work on his bashes. That was pretty much the only problem we had. These need to back up on it.
Meteor strike!
Anyway, this is all team issues. I don't think any of this was your fault. Of course, you know, hitting sleeps on the Doomfist that's attacking you, so it's helpful, but... You never use Nano. I think it's just because you kept dying, though.
Score.
We should have had that, man.
Ready for battle.
I like how I'm still on this map, even though we're... No, we go up. So look at this, right? Isn't this cool? PogChamp! Isn't this so cool?
5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Round 2. Capture.
And we're up here. Whoa. This is just us being bad. And there we go. I should have watched. Gold down this, yeah. Because of this nasty rollout.
Check this out.
Look at this guy, dude. Holy moly. That's insane. Oh, man. Alright, anyway. Skip forward. I doubt any of this was your fault. I think this was mostly Lee. But let's watch for fun.
Nothing's gonna stop.
Nice right click. Just can't stall any shoot, please. Nice shot. Good shot.
Yeah.
reasons we play McCree is because of flashbang. Like, when someone dives in like that, just like 180 flash them, fan, or whatever you want to do with them after that point. But that's one reason we play him. You have to use that. It's so, so important if it's good. If we're starting a fight, you can't just be focused on the Lucio that's 15 miles away from everybody. You have to be focused on the fight itself, especially if you have ult. So let me explain it this way, right? This is how bunker comp works, right? So we're playing bunker versus bunker, so it's going to look like this. The goal is to break the opponent's shield. I need to change colors. The goal is to break the opponent's shield and then kill them after that. You have all this, everyone's damage, so let's go back here.
Meet your strike.
Establishing defense point. We should not be split like this. So if you look at their comp, right? They've got Doomfist doing whatever he's doing. They've got Lucio doing whatever he's doing. But they've got one, two, three, four people looking in the same direction. It tells you where they're looking too. Where they're facing. Whereas us, we got one group here doing jack squat and another group here doing jack squat. What it should be is these three should be here, and all six of us should be right behind the shield and just focusing their shield. That's what should be happening, because Hanzo and McCree have extremely good shield break. They break shields very, very fast, and so does Lucio, and so does Hog. And so does Orisa. And then Anna's just kind of there. You kind of get the point, though, of how bunker works. So each of these comps have different strengths and weaknesses and how they work and how they're supposed to function. And you have to know how you function into these comps. Your point is to flash people that try to break said comp with Doomfist, Ball, that kind of stuff. That's your job. As well as breaking the opponent's shield and possibly, if we go for like a halt over the shield, just dinking heads, because it's pretty easy, right? Anyway. Get picked up one by one.
Meteor strike.
What happened there is we just split up too much, and we're not very versatile. No, so.
Oh.
with
the Meteor Strike.
Okay, on to the next map. Did he play Zen at any point today? Havana has the same issues as that map. We're just not very versed in Bunker and how it works. And I need to go over that with you guys. Did we play it on Blizzard World? We played it for a little bit, didn't we? But then we swapped, like, immediately. You played it a little bit on Paris, didn't you? Let's watch that. It's like the very end, I think.
Welcome to Paris.
I just wanted to make sure that I get a glimpse of your Zen play.
Ready for battle. Objective lost.
It's
I know you're not going to be playing Zen anymore, but just for funsies. I feel bad that I'm swapping you so many times, but I really just want to fix our hero pool desperately. It's so bad. It's so hard to swap comps. It's so hard to do anything. Every person who's playing here is playing heroes all the time. Me, Carlo, I think you've done a great job. Should have been standing out in the open there. But hey. And then that doesn't matter. Alright, so you kind of understand what I'm talking about Sombra, about McCree. Makes sense. When you start learning Brig, I'll help you out on that. Other than that, so right now on Sombra, you need things to work on. There's a lot to work on. Number one being EMP placement. This sound is really annoying. Can I turn that off, please?
Enemies reviving.
Fantastic. Okay. So, yes. Number one being EMP placement. How and where to place your EMPs so that it gets the maximum amount of people possible. Okay. As well as supports that have defensive ults, if applicable. Okay. Number two being APM, you always need to be stealthed, you need to be moving, you need to be translocating somewhere, you need to be doing something, hacking a health pack that's applicable to your team, getting EMP ult charge, all that stuff. So, you can't just be sitting there just walking from point to point. It just makes you look like an idiot. Ice had this problem for a while, but then he fixed it. Hopefully we'll get you there too. And then focusing on how to play on whether to play offensive or defensive. I'm not worried about how to do it yet. I'm worried about when to do it. You need to know when to do that and start to know that time. I kind of went over earlier kind of the idea of who's the threat, identify the threat, how do you kill the threat? Okay. So Bastion, you need to go up to him and kill him, obviously, but he's going to be by himself. He's not going to be in your backline. A Doomfist or a Ball is going to be in your backline, so therefore you have to play defensive. That kind of makes sense. I know you like the kind of, if this happens, I do this. So there it is for you. Okay. O/D. Okay. Does that all make sense? Hope so. I'll do one for you when you start playing Brig. And probably again for you on Summer, because you're going to be playing it a lot until she gets nerfed into the ground, which she inevitably will at some point, and then you're going to have to play something different. So, there you go.